This is Donna from Many Books Army, and I am here today with my latest Graphic 45 brand ambassador tutorial. This month we're talking about techniques, and so I wanted to share with you one of my favorite techniques that I have developed, and I think you're going to have a lot of fun with it. These are called drop-ins, and drop-ins, if you followed me, you know that you've seen them. I've done several sets of them. These are interactive little units that you create completely separately, and then you can put them into on any scrapbook page, and it adds an interactive element to an otherwise plain page. It's a really easy way to add like the flaps and pockets and fun stuff to a plain page, or you can use them separately. And one of the things that I've talked about, the ones I've done before, I've added to albums, but as I have discussed in previous things, you can also add them to cards. And so that's what we're doing today, is we are adding a interactive drop-in unit to the front of a card. So I'm going to walk you through this, and I'm going to tell you a little, show you a little bit about the other drop-ins that I've done, and then I'm going to teach you how to make this. So fun. All right. So this is the drop-in card version using Graphic 45's very, very beautiful fairy dust collection. I'm so excited that I got a chance to play with this again. Any excuse, really. So I play with it a lot. We're going to talk about that in a minute too. So this is the drop-in unit on the front. That's been it's been created separately and then just attached to the front cover of this card. And then I had to dress the card up too. So I'll teach you a little bit about that also. I used several of Graphic 45's tags. I used three of the regular size tags and two of the little tags, and I altered them a little bit, and we'll talk about that also. So on this front cover, you have one little wee tag in the bottom pocket. Super, super cute. And yes, of course, I had to decorate the back and add cute little things, because if you're going to give me cute little stickers, I'm going to use them. So this is one of the ATC tags cut down just a little bit and die cut with one of the cut apart cards from the 8x8 collection. This is the full size ATC card. These little cut apart cards are perfect for these, just perfect. And again, and on the back, because what's more fun than a wee tag with a wee little tag? Come on. So I know I can't be stopped. It's just, you're going to give me, I mean, it's a fairy theme with fairies and elves and little teeny wee things. You've got to have little teeny surprises in there. So, and then in the big pocket, so this is like a library pocket. And it's going to have two, as you can see, there's a pocket here, then a sleeve pocket and a full pocket there. And then this unit was made and just stuck onto this card. You can stick it onto anything, or you could use it just by itself, and we'll talk about that too. So this is the main unit, his little fairy charm that I hung from the top there. A little stamp, one of the little border cuts here, and then out of the way. And then this opens this way, and you have the cut apart border strips here, a little stamp, and then this, because like I said, you have to have little wee surprises. This is a little teeny booklet. Come on, how adorable is that? I just think it's the cutest thing ever. So that just tucks in there. It adds a little bit of bulk to this, but I couldn't resist. And then this also opens this way. Move it down a little bit. So the whole thing is actually an accordion card. So this opens up like that. Or you can open it up the back way, like that. I just love this paper. So much fun to play with it again. So this is actually three of these tags. And I cut the tops off of two of them so that you could just have the one part at the top there. And then I took the other little cutoffs and I added them to the side of the card, because why waste something if you don't have to? So this is the back of the card, front of the card. So then this unties here, and you'll see a little bit. So the ribbon just slides through that front hole, but it stays tied to the back, so it doesn't fall apart, doesn't fall off, and then you have to wonder where your ribbon went. Then I also hung a few little charms here that I made from the sticker sheet. Cute little mushroom on the back, little sticker on the front, says make a wish. These are stickers front and back. And then there's another little gemstone charm on there because it looked like fairy dust. Come on. So that's a little tag topper there. And then I also added some fun stuff to the inside of the card. So over here, I put a spot that you could stamp or write your little note to whomever the card is going to. I put a little tuck spot pocket over here, made a little tag, decorated the back with some of the stickers. So cute, put the little sticker corners on here. These are all from the sticker sheet. So super fun. And a little hint on the on this piece here. I've attached it to the card, but what I usually do is I wait until I write what I want to write on it, and then I put it in, because you know how when you're trying to figure out what you want to write, or you run out of room, or you, like, I might do like five of them before I get the one that I'm actually willing to put and a card. So that way it's no stress. You can take as many times as you want to get it written exactly the way that you want, as neat and tidy as you want, and then put it into the card and add all your cute little stuff around it. So that you don't have to worry about the pressure of making it perfect the first time. I don't know if you're like me, but I sweat bullets over filling out cards. I never do it right the first time. So that's fun. So this is your, it's an A7 size card. The card is 10 inches across by six and a half. Let's just get the ruler out and make sure that I have this right. Yeah, 6.5 by 10. And then if you add the little tabs on the outside, it extends it by another inch. So that makes it all the way out to 5.75. Now, if you weren't adding these, this actually would still fit in a regular envelope. And I'll show you. So this tucks into the library pocket, and then this tucks into the behind the sleeve, and then this one tucks into the front. And where's my envelope? I have one. I know I brought it over here. All right. So this is the card and envelope that I use, and it's pre-scored, and you can just make yours out of cardstock. You have the size there, the 10 by 6.5, and then it's just scored at 5 inches. But this was a card and envelope that came already like this. So technically this would fit fine in here. Knocked off your little ribbon there. But these little tabs sticking out is what's going to keep it from closing. So if you didn't have those on there, this would close. It's bulky. Now, if it was me and I was sending this in the mail, I would put it in a little, I might put it in the envelope, but I would put it in a padded mailer. And if you want to add the cute little tag toppers to the side, then you definitely are going to need a little bit of a padded mailer or something to send it out, unless you're going to hand deliver it. So, all right. So I want to talk a little bit about drop-ins. So I have done 3 different sets of drop-ins so far, and there's a 4th set coming soon. But this has been July actually. So I started off with one of Graphic 45's big chunky pocket and tag albums. And then there are 6 drop-ins in here, and each one is different. So, and again, it's just a unit that you can fully make separately and then just add to a page. So this is just a plain album page. This book comes with a plain page, a pocket page, and a plain page. So this is just plain on both sides. And then I added this little unit, and I added a unit here on this one. So it's a super fun way to add little interactive elements, and you can design the whole book, and then these are just made separately and they're just stuck on there. You put tape on the back and you just stick them on there. It's a little waterfall here. So if you want to know how to add interactive elements, you don't want to have to try to build them into the book, especially if it's a pre-made book like this one, then you just make the little drop-ins. And the drop-ins are all different sizes. They're all of them are different. Not all of them will fit in every book. Obviously, if you're having a small mini, the big ones aren't going to fit, but there's little ones also. So there's lots of variety. And you can also just make this for what it is and put it in an envelope and ship it off if you want to. This one is made more specifically that way. But these, again, can also be put on the front of a card just for some really interactive fun. Add some little photos, whatever. It almost makes it like a teeny little folio that you're sending to somebody, which I love. So this one had six different drop-ins in this one with the ABC Primer collection. And then I also did this was the drop-ins number 1 series. And then number three, I'll just skip ahead. Number 3 also used the Graphic 45 album, the ivory version of the same exact album. And then this one also had all the cute little interactive elements. And again, they're all different, super cute little tags here. So this one was kind of like 12 grades. I had a first grade, second grade kind of could go on each page, because there was 6 units all together with 2 sides. This has 6 units with 2 sides, so for the 12 days of Christmas, it worked really, really well. So same kind of thing. So this is day 1. But again, on the front of each one of these units, there's a different drop-in, and they all have a different size, and they all do a different thing. This is actually a little booklet. Super fun. Cute little tags that go in a pocket, because I'm all about the wee things. So there's 6 in this book also. And then for people who wanted to make their own album, the drop-ins 2, this is using the 12 Days of Christmas collection from Graphic 45. Then on drop-ins 2, I designed an album that was similar, a little bit similar in style to this. It's a little bit wider in the spine, and it has the same general number of pages. This one has 5 pages, and then you have this, the 6th part is going to be on the inside cover. This uses Tropical Travelogue. And same thing, so you're gonna get this really fun, and this one has, they have fun little interactive units on the front and back cover also that are the same, little slant pocket there, tags. But again, the front of each one of these has a really cute little interactive piece. All of them are different. This one has a little fold out also. Little tag here, tag there. This is a little policy envelope that you make from one sheet of paper. This is worth the whole price of admission just to learn how to make the one sheet wonder policy envelope with this, with the pleated side. I love this one the most. Cute little ones here. So you can kind of see what I'm talking about. Really, really fun little idea of a way to spruce up any album. All of these, there are tutorials for all of these. For the ones with the pre-made albums, the tutorial is for the how to make the drop-ins, but I do include a cutting guide for how I cut the papers for this. So you can use the same exact collection from them or any collection that you want. And then this one you can get a couple different ways. It has the album by itself, it has the drop-ins by itself, or you can get the combo that has the album and the drop-ins and make the whole thing. So, but today you're gonna make a solo drop-in that actually fits on a greeting card. So let's go ahead and let me get my stuff and then we will get started. Okay, so I've pre-cut things so we don't have to take forever. So you can actually make this entire little unit here from one 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And then I used two of the ATC size Graphic 45 ivory tags, and I used three of the regular size ivory tags. There are six in a package of these, and there's nine in a package of these, so each one of these packages would make three of these. I think there's six. I know there's nine of these. Is there six of these? Yeah. So you could get three of these units from one pack of each of those. Then in order to cut the mats for these, I also did use the dies. Graphic 45 is great. They have these brand new dies that cut, they don't cut the tags. You get the tags from Graphic 45 with these lovely big grommets in them. And then these dies cut the mats that fit on the tag so that you don't have to try to cut it out yourself. So you get, that's what it does. It cuts this blue, this the actual pattern paper mat that you're gonna decorate it with. So the great thing is the large tag comes with the little ATC size in it. And then there's the square tag, which we're not using in this project. And then this is the regular size. So I use this one here and the little guy out of this one. Then they have some fun other dies in there as well that are awesome. So highly recommend if you work with Graphic 45, and why wouldn't you? So because they have fun stuff like this. Okay, so one sheet of paper, a card and an envelope, and this, and you could make this entire thing, so, which we're gonna do. Okay. So first up, all right, so I'm gonna take everything out of here so you can kind of see this background piece. Okay, so there's a mat in the back, that is your base. Okay, that is this mat here. And then I did a little decorative punching on the corners just to give it a little bit of cuteness. So you could just corner around this, or you could leave it like it is. But We Are Memory Keepers makes these really great things called corner chompers. Look at these big bad boys. So they will cut through metal, they will cut through stacks of paper, through board. I mean, they're really, really strong. But what I like about them is, in addition to, I use the quarter, there's one that has a quarter inch and half inch that I use all the time. And you'll use it on this one to rerun the corners of things that you're cutting off. But they also make decorative corners. Now back in the day, they used to make one called Deco Stub and they made one called Cloud Scallop. I love them both dearly, but they discontinued both of these. And now they make one where they took the stub from this one and the scallop from this one and they put them together in one of these. Why? Nobody knows. I really wish they had both of these because it gives you so many more options. But these two do work really well together, the stub and the scallop, and that's what I used here. I did the scallop on the cream and I did the little stub, which is like a ticket stub corner on the pattern mat that goes on top of it. So. There you go. But if anyone is ever talking to We Are Memory Keepers, tell them, bring these back. Seriously, bring them back. Okay, so this is your base. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna So what you do is you open up this, it has these little flanges, and then you just slide the corner in and chomp. Okay, so that gives us our cute little corners. Super simple. And then we have our, and this I should tell you. Okay, so the measurements for this back mat are 4 1/4 by 5. And there is a list of all the measurements below, and there's a list of, there's a link also to the blog post on Graphic 45's blog site, and all of the information is there also. So you have it in many different places, but I'm gonna tell it to you also as we're working. So 4 1/4 by 5 is your base. And then we're gonna make a deep pocket. So this is one of the techniques that you're gonna learn today as well. In addition to making this fun little drop-in unit, you're also gonna learn how to make a deep pocket. And this pocket is has a 1/8 inch side on all three sides, because that's what's gonna let you put this nice thick book inside. Okay, so so that works out really well. All right, so to get that side, you are going to score at 1/2 inch and 5/8 inches from one end, then turn it around, do that from the other side. And we're gonna talk a little bit about orientation. So I know everybody, some people have their score lines going this way, some people have the zero mark over here. What I like to do is reference, instead of trying to explain where to put the ruler, and I call this the ruler that you're gonna score down away from, I work with what I say landscape and portrait. So if you're looking at a photo, that's landscape photo, and that would be a portrait. Okay, so this is landscape, which means that the long edge is against the ruler, and you're scoring across, down away from that edge. And then you're gonna turn this portrait, and you're gonna score 1/2 inch and 5/8 again. So when you're done, you've got three sides that are scored and one side open. This open side is the top of the pocket. All right, now before we continue on with this, as you can see, as anyone who's, if you've been with me for 5 minutes, you know that I think it's really adorable when you put a little notch in your pocket. And you don't have to do that, but it's a really fun thing to do. It makes it look a little prettier. I did not do it in these because they're so skinny. It would have detracted a little bit from the patterning, but I did it in the larger pocket. So you wanna measure, so if this mat is 5 1/2 by 4 1/8, and that 1/8 is just giving that little 1/8 gusset there. So wait a minute, maybe I got it 4 1/4, what did I do? Let me look at my little crib notes here. I wanna make sure I'm telling you, yeah, 4 1/8. So we got 5 1/2 by 4 1/8, okay? So 5 1/2, you wanna pick the halfway mark of 5 1/2 is 2 3/4. So this top corner here is gonna slide over to the 2 3/4 mark on this ruler. And then you're going to punch, and that gives you a little notch. And then when you do your mat for this, the mat for this is 4 inches, I think. Yes, 4 inches. So you would notch, but you would put the corner at 2 inches. It's always just the halfway point and notch. And then it'll fit perfectly on top of this pocket. So that's what I love it. All right, so now for another little handy tip. All right, so we've got this little skinny 1/8 inch gusset all on all three sides here. And I don't know about you, but trying to fold on both of those lines and not mangle it is really challenging. So what I like to do is use the sharper edge of my ruler to help me fold. Now the trick with that is you wanna always, you're gonna wanna do it, your mind is gonna think that the logical way to do it is vertically, but the shadow of this actually diminishes. You can't really see the line because it kind of casts a little bit of a shadow. You wanna do it horizontally. You wanna have it this way so that the ruler is going left or right. And you want the sharp edge to line up with the top score line, so that, I can't see here because my lighting over here is not as great, because that way the ruler is on top of the other score line. So when you fold this against the edge of the ruler, it can't inadvertently fold anything but that score line. Other score line is hidden underneath the ruler. So you always wanna work, the score line you're bending needs to be at the top edge, the topmost score line. So we're going to put that on the edge there, and then lift this up against it, and that gets your one, and then turn it around. So the other score line is now at the top. And I'm gonna pull this down so I can see it, and then I'll move it back up into camera range, because, so I don't goof it up. Okay, so here, then you do the short edge. So now you've got both of these, see, ta-da. All right, so, and what I like to do is and then go ahead and use your bone folder to get both of those nice and crisp. I'm gonna fold the other one back again. And do that one nice and crisp. And that way you have this really nice, sharp little, so see that? So it's got like a little 1/8 inch little gusset there, right? Then lay it flat again and do the same thing, repeat the same thing on the other sides. And again, I'm gonna move it down out of camera range for just a second because my lighting is such that I can't see. So there's your edge there. Turn it around, line it up against the 5/8 inch line. I'll stick my head right in the camera. And then lift up against the edge of the ruler. And once again, you have your nice little gusset on the side. And then one last time on the other side. And this is basically just a starter. All right, so you wanna, this gets your fold going. But then you do wanna take your bone folder and actually make it nice and crisp. And then fold in. And if you have to go back and restart it on the against the ruler to make sure you've got the right edge, do so. And I'm gonna do that on this side because I don't wanna end up scoring in the middle. All right. So there's my nice sharp little gusset on that side. All right. So now we're gonna attach the pocket, we're gonna use score tape. In this case, we're applying tape to the 1/2 inch panels on all three sides. And 1/2 inch tape is gonna be too wide. It would go all the way from the score line to the edge and it would be sticky, the edges would be sticky. So you wanna use 3/8 inch tape. If you have 1/4 and 1/8, you can just use those side by side. But put this right in the middle of your 1/2 inch panel. You do not want any tape on the little 1/8 inch gusset. That's gonna be the sides of your pocket. Nothing is gonna touch those. So get that on all three sides. Okay. All right. Now you have to cut these bottom corners out. You wanna cut all the way in to the where the 5/8 inch lines intersect. So to the second score line. All the way in, and I will lift this up to the camera so you can see. All right. So all the way in to the second score line. So there's no more score lines beyond where you're cutting. All right, and then you want to go back and just miter the 1/2 inch panel, the corners. All right, so don't cut the corners of the 1/8 inch part, or your little corners on your pocket will have holes, and you don't want that. Nobody wants holes in their corners, in their pocket corners. Okay, so we're gonna just miter the corners, and again, I'll lift this up to the camera so you can see it. All right, so we've just mitered the corners of the 1/2 inch panel. So now turn this, get this out of the way, turn this over so the tape side faces the table. And you're gonna fold these in like this, and that's gonna make your deep pocket. So see how it's got the, so it has those little 1/8 inch sides on it? Nifty, and that's what your little, that's what this book is gonna slide into, because that's, is now deep enough to wrap around that. Does that make sense? All right, so make sure that everything is where it's supposed to be. I'm gonna still make sure that this side is correct. I feel like this one's a little mangly. All right, and then before you attach it to the base, you wanna make sure that your width of your pocket when you folded it is the same width as this, and it is. All right, so then peel off the paper. And what I like to do is peel off the paper on the side pieces first. Maybe. All right, fold those and make sure your 1/8 inch sides are standing upright. And then I kind of fold that bottom in and let it, the corner kind of stick. So it kind of keeps it in its little, in its pocket shape. That's a little trick there. So this bottom piece is kind of sticking to the sides now that they've been exposed. And that keeps your nice little pocket shape. And then this actually lines up exactly with the bottom and the sides of your mat. So there and there, and your sides should line up, and ta-da! Okay, so this is actually gonna slide into like that. All right, so this is that. All right, so now we're gonna add the two little pockets to the front. Now, there are, this is not a pocket on top of a pocket. This is a full pocket like we just made with the side, bottom, and side. This, on the other hand, is just a sleeve, right? There's no need to put a whole pocket on top of a whole pocket with the bottom. And both of these go all the way to the bottom. That goes to the bottom and that goes to the bottom. There is a way to do the sleeves where they have a little catch here, but we're not doing that today. So this is good. Each one of these pockets is going to go to the bottom, but it's a way to make it look like you've got two pockets here, but both of them use the same communal pocket space at the bottom. Okay? Nifty. All right. So the first pocket, the base pocket, is 5 1/4 by 1 1/2. No, it's supposed to be 5 1/4 by 2. I knew I screwed that up. All right, let me get another piece of paper. I'll be right back. And we're back. The magic of movies. So, all right, much different. Okay, so 5 1/4 by 2. Big difference. All right. So you're going to score it the same way that we did this pocket, but it doesn't have little side gussets to it. So in this case, it's just a 1/2 inch landscape from either end. So the long edge is against your ruler, so landscape, and then 1/2 inch portrait, all right? So when you're done, it is basically 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, all right? And then, so super simple, we're not notching this pocket. I know, it's hard to believe, but it's a little shallow and I like the patterning the way that it is on the pocket, so the stamps, and I didn't want to notch into those. So I managed to resist the urge. It's shocking. All right, so we're going to put tape on the 3 panels just like before. There's no 1/8 inch gusset this time. It's just a regular old pocket. All right, so tape on your 1/2 inch panels, and the same thing, you're going to cut out the corners. But in this case, we can kind of jump ahead a little bit and we can go right to I go right to cutting my mitering my corners. But I don't cut straight across the corner, because invariably I'll cut the little point of the corner off, and then when you fold your edges in, it's not really a nice sharp corner. So I cut it at an angle, get to that part, and then I change the angle a little bit and I move. So in at an angle here, and then change a little bit and move. And then I like to do my top corners too, because it makes things slide in and out of the pocket a little bit easier as well. So here you go. All 3 of your panels have the corners mitered, then they're just going to be folded under. Now the trick for this, right, when you're attaching a pocket, see how it's big and bouncy, is you want to take your bone folder and you want to burnish it really well this way. All right, nice and firm, make it nice and crisp, but then turn it over and burnish again on both sides of the folds. All right, because now look how flat that sits, much, much better. So that makes it really, really easy to see when you're attaching it. All right, same thing, take the sides off first, all right, and then put the bottom flap second. Plus the other thing about this too is it keeps this flap on the outside, so when you're sliding things into the pocket, they don't tend to hit this tab quite as easily as they might otherwise. All right, so you take the paper off the sides first, and then off the bottom, and this just lines up right at the bottom of your piece. The sides there and the bottom there, and now you have a pocket here and a pocket here. All right, so now we're going to add the sleeve that kind of makes a little divider there. They're both tags are going to go into this pocket, but it kind of creates the look of two pockets. All right, so our sleeve, get these out of the way. Oh, and you know what? I did have the right pocket piece. I picked up the sleeve piece. See, I was on the ball. I was a little worried about me. No, I'm not. Okay, like I only had 4 mats to cut. Like how hard could it be? And I've managed to mess it up, but I didn't mess it up, so now I feel better. All right, so the sleeve mat is 5 1/4 by 1 1/2. That's the one we were measuring earlier that I thought was wrong, but I just said the wrong mat. So 5 1/4 by 1 1/2, that's going to be your sleeve. Now this is scored differently. This is not scored like a regular pocket. This is a sleeve, not a pocket. So we are going to do the 1/2 inch at each end. Okay. But then we're going to score right down the middle of this 1 1/2 inch. We're going to score it 3/4 of an inch. All right. We are not going to fold on this middle score line. This is just a mark line so we know how far into slide this when we get done. All right. So the way that you prep a sleeve mat is you're only going to put tape from that center score line up to the top on both sides because you're going to cut this bottom part of the half inch panel off so that you can put tape on it, but you're going to waste the tape. So there's no point in it. All right, so we just need to put a little teeny bit of tape. So, because this is a little skinny little sleeve on this wee little pocket. So you're just going to put a little piece of tape on the top from the score line up. So your score line is here and you have score line here and here. So you're just putting tape on that top part. All right. Then you're going to cut in on that 3/4 inch score line just to where those two score lines intersect, and then you're going to angle your scissors, and it doesn't matter what angle this piece isn't going to show, and you're going to miter that corner. All right, do the same thing here, cut in to where the score lines intersect, and then slide your scissors in, angle it down, and cut off the corner. Ta-da! Don't cut off the sides of the tape. So, and if you do, then just put tape on these because you just took your tape off. All right. Now you have to very, 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 very slightly, because these are teeny tiny little tabs. So just miter these just a hair. Just take a teeny bit of an angle off of these because they're so little. But you do want to take them. You do want to take a little bit of the edge off. All right. So this is your sleeve. Now it does not. Again, it doesn't matter if these angles are even. If one's deeply angled and one's not, because this isn't going to show. This is the part that's going to tuck in. So we're going to fold these little tabs under so the tape side faces the table, and get my bone folder here. We're going to take off the paper off the tape. All right. Now, so this little mitered panel, this 3/4 inch panel, is going to slide into the pocket, and you're going to stop where that 3/4 inch score line is. Now you want to test if for some reason you haven't cut, you've left a little bit here, you didn't cut right to the score line, then you're going to want to take it back out and do that, because otherwise you're not going to be able to get it all the way into that 3/4 inch score line. But I think mine is okay. You know what, mine actually could use a little teeny, see, just a little teeny more, so that when I slide it in, it goes all the way in. All right. So that little 3/4 inch score line, then stick the sides down, and there you go. So you have a pocket, well, you have pocket here, pocket here, pocket here. So these tags are gonna go like this, and then we're gonna cut this one down a little bit, and that's gonna go like that. So see, they both go all the way to the bottom here, but you have like two separate little pockets. And that is this pocket. We just added this little sleeve. Nifty. All right, so this is your unit. Okay, this is your unit. It's separate from your card. You could take this, you could put it on anything. So if you have a scrapbook page, a blank scrapbook page, I'm gonna flip this up. You just put tape on the back and you just stick it down, and now you have this interactive unit on any blank page. Super simple. Now we're gonna add things to this really fun little, it's like a library pocket with double pocket on the front. All right, so now I didn't want both of the tags to be the same size. I thought they looked cuter if one was a little smaller. Don't they look cuter? Come on, they look cuter. So what I did was I just cut a half inch off the bottom of one of the ATC tags. Now, the sizes of these tags are also listed below. If you wanna make your own rectangle tags or square tags or do whatever you want with paper, you don't have access to the Graphic 45 tags, you can do that. The sizes are there. But these are so cute, and one package will make three of these, so come on. I would totally do it. All right, I did totally do it. So, all right, let me get my cutter. All right, so we're just gonna cut a big old cutter here. We're just gonna cut a half inch off the bottom of this tag. All right. And then we're gonna take this corner rounder, and these are 1/4 inch. So one's 1/4 inch, one's 1/2. We're gonna do the quarter and just re-round those corners. See, that's stinking cute. So now you have one big tag, or big, ATC size big. And then you have one little baby tag. It goes like that, nifty. All right, so then the last thing we have to do is we need to make this little tri-fold book. All right, so what we have left is this book here. All right. So one of these is the full size tag, and then the other ones, I just cut the, I have two of them here. Nope. I just cut the little top off. So I literally lined this up, and I'm gonna do it right now. So on your cutter or your trimmer, all right, mine's a guillotine, but you can do it. So I don't know if you can see, but I'm just gonna line this up so that the top edge of the tag is right against the cutting edge of my guillotine cutter. Same thing if you were doing a slide cutter. So let me get that in there. So you're just gonna take the top off. So that becomes just a, I think when you take it off, it's 5 by 3 7/8. Yeah, 5 by 3 7/8. And keep this, because this is what we're gonna use on the card. You don't have to, but why wouldn't you? It's got that cute little ramen in it. Why would you wanna waste that? All right, so now we have our tag and our mat and our mat. So this is our booklet, all right? And all we have to do is attach these panels. So, and again, keep these little guys because we're gonna attach these to the card. All right, and I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So here are our little attachment strips, okay? So you need to take these, and these are 1 inch by 4.5. Okay, so I'll show you with the ruler, but so 1 inch by 4.5. You're gonna score them both portrait. So the short edge is gonna be up against your ruler, and you're scoring the long distance at 1/2 right down the middle. These are 1 inch strips at 1/2 right down the middle. And that is the last of our scoring for the evening. Okay. And then you're going to put your tape, 3/8 inch tape, on one side of both panels. Both 1/2 inch panels, I mean, okay? This is a 1 inch piece, and I have a 1/2 inch panel, 1/2 inch panel. So just tape on one side. The other side does not have tape. All right. And you wanna do the same thing that I was talking about with the pockets. All right, you wanna fold on the score line, and then you wanna burnish on both sides. So fold on the score line so the tape is on the outside facing you, and then turn it over, burnish on both sides so it's really nice and crisp. Do that with both of them. Okay, now to miter the corners of these, some people want to cut from the corner, from the folded edge point to the open side. I don't, because I can't catch that corner exactly. I always end up going in a little bit, and then my strip ends up being shorter. So I always work from the open side to the top. It doesn't matter how angled it is, but that way you can aim directly at that point, right? So you'd cut it right to that point, and you cut right to that point. All right, so when you open that up, it should look like that. The little points, not divots. Same thing, cut from the open edge towards the point. Open edge towards the point. You can even just get your blades right on there, all right? Now, what's really important with attaching these panels is that the folded edge of this strip here lines up exactly with the edge. And maybe I have this out of range, probably this whole time, right? You haven't been able to see anything. So this is what happens when I'm below the camera. All right, so you wanna make sure that this folded edge is exactly along the edge of this. Don't have it sitting in a little bit, and don't have it pass. You want it right on the edge with the points between the two curved corners. All right, so I'm gonna do that first. And you wanna center it top to bottom. Get it right on the edge like that. And then you wanna take these and actually just have, don't overlap it, and don't leave a gap, just have them touch. All right, peel the paper off the other panel. Yep, I use my own trick here and I'm not doing it. All right, so just line them up so they're just exactly touching. Make sure the top and bottom edges are even. Don't have it up like, you know, up and down like this. Make sure it's correct. And then just seal that over. And take your bone folder. All right, and that gives you one panel. All right. Now we're going to turn this over because the other panel is going to fold over the front this way. So we're going to turn it over like this because this panel is going to fold that way. So this is going to be your seam. So one seam is on this side and one seam is on the other side. Or seam, I see like attachment hinge. The seam that you can see where it's attached. Again, make sure the folded edge is right at the edge of your tag. And go ahead and take the paper off. Line up the top and bottom edges of your tags. Make sure they are even. And press. And ta-da! There you go. And this fits in here like that. And that is your drop-in. All right, so this goes, again, on any page. Let's pull this out. So, like, see this blank page here? So this is a blank page in your album. You put tape on the back of this envelope and you stick it on there, and you have this really great little interactive unit with pockets and a whole folio that you pull out of the pocket there. Really, really neat. Now, the one thing you have to know about these when you're putting them into albums, you would not be able to put it here on the inside of this because there's no gusset here, and this would be, see how it's too thick. So you need to put these on the front or back of a page where there is a gusset in between to take up to allow you to have that space, okay? So that's the trick when you're adding it to an album. The great thing about adding it to the front of a card is you don't have to worry because it's not in anything. It can be as big as you want. As long as you can find a padded mailer to stick it in, you can make it as complicated and as involved as you want. And trust me, I have. So this is the little guy. So this is your little library pocket with three tags. So this goes here. This slides in here. And where's our little tag? Little tag. And that goes in there. So this is your greeting card drop-in. And you can use this on, and you could actually just use this by itself. You don't have to stick it to a card. You could take this, just add a decorative mat to the back of this. There's no decorative mat on the back of this one because it's stuck to the card. Just put a decorative mat here and just stick this in an envelope if you want to. Where's my envelope? My envelope is right here. So you could just take this and put this in an envelope and send it. Ta-da, super cute. But why not put it on a card? That's what I'm saying. So, all right, so here is our card. This is the same card base that I used. And these are our little grommets that I attached to the edges of these cards. So what I did was I used, on the back side of the grommet, there's a little bit more space between the back of the grommet and the edge of the paper. The front, the grommet comes almost all the way down because it's really thick. It's a thick ring on the front, but the back is really skinny. So you're gonna put a thin line of glue here, and you're gonna attach this little strip to it. And you wanna use glue and not tape because you want this to be like a permanent thing, all right? And then all you need to do is put your 3/8 inch tape there and attach that to the back, or excuse me, you want to put your tape on the front side, tape here, and then you attach it so that the edge of the tag touches the edge of the card, like that. Same thing here. Now what I did was I attached the back one first, then I just closed the card, and when I did the front one, I knew I could make them exactly even, because I could just line it up with wherever the back one was. So. And then as far as the rest of this is just a mat that I added little stickers to, and this is a tuck spot. There's glue here and here to make this into a little corner pocket. So, but you can, now your card, you can decorate or do whatever you want with, but there you have it. So super cute. Let me tell you a little bit about the paper collection also. So the fun thing about these little drop-ins too is they don't use a lot of paper. You know, I don't know if you're like me, but I have played with this collection several times, more than several times. I would play with it every day if I could. I really, really love it. I've made a couple of projects. If you look on my YouTube channel, you'll see a traveler's notebook made with this, and you'll see a fall folder mini made with this, and now you have this cute little drop-in. But if you're like me, you have like scraps left over. So what I use to make this, just so you know, is I use scraps left over from the 8x8 pad. I use scraps from five of the 8 sheets. Three of the sheets I didn't use at all, but the other five I use pieces parts to decorate the tag and to decorate the pocket and to do the, and for the card. I did use the striped the border stripes to do the little tags, but the rest of this is actually decorated with what was left over from the patterns and solids. And so I used, like, so these are the color, three colors. I didn't use any of the green. I don't think I just used these three colors. So, and again, just to, that was mostly, it was more of this was used to decorate the card than to decorate the actual tags. But I think the backs of the tags have, where's my, I think the backs of these are the solid. Yeah. So this is from the patterns and solids, the little green and the cute little tag, come on. Now, as far as the one sheet of 8.5 by 11, you do have one little piece left over from that. It's enough to do this tag here, but you would need a second sheet of 8.5 by 11 to do whatever matting you want to put inside the card. And if you want to make these cute little, any other cute little things, you won't really have quite that much scrap. If you have any, I keep a lot of my scraps for my cardstock for just exactly this reason. And come on, to make this little teeny book, let me give you the measurements. So the measurements for these are not in the thing below because it was just how I designed this particular one. It's not part of the foundation, but this one is 2.25 by 1.375 because that was the size of the stamp. So, and then this one is actually taped down, but this one has glue here, here, and here. I use art glitter glue with a really fine metal tip, so it makes teeny, teeny little lines, which is really sweet. And the same thing on the back of this tag here. I just did glue on the edges, so the top edge is unsealed, and I could just put my little tag in, my little tag in a tag. A wee tag. Life doesn't get any better than that when you like wee things, and I love wee things. So, and I also, I had used the 12 by 12 collection for one of my things, but I didn't use the sticker sheet. So I used the sticker sheet for this project just to add decor. It's not necessary, but again, if you have it, I was so excited that I had an opportunity to use it because I hadn't had a chance to use these before. So I used these decorating all over, but I also used these to make these little tags that I hung from the side here. So this is a sticker front and back. I just put both stickers on either side of a piece of chipboard and then I cut it out. And on this one, I did a sticker on the front and a scrap of the cardstock on the back. And then I added one of these little mushroom stickers and I trimmed it down to fit so that it wouldn't just be plain on the back. And then I added this little charm is actually hanging from the same ring as this little tag. And then there is a little, I used this fairy charm when I used this paper for an earlier project, and I had some of the little fairies left over. So I added a little fairy charm, and it's just tied in the ribbon. So it's not attached. It's super easy to attach. You just tied the ribbon in a knot, slid the ring on, then made the bow. And then on this, as I said before, I tied the ribbon to the back of this so that when you open the card, the ribbon doesn't just fall to the floor and then you don't know where it went, or someone stepping out or the dog runs off with it, or you know, whatever. If you tie it to the back, let me get this out of the way. If you tie it to the back, then all you have to do is just put the end of the front piece through the hole. I must not be able to do it. All right, you don't even have to tie. You could tie again if you want to, but basically it's already tied. This is just laying in there, so you don't even need to. You don't even need to tie it again. You can just go ahead and make your bow, or not. Make a loop big enough to actually poke it through this time. There we go. All right, and then get it pretty. So what I like to do is pull my ends of my bow way far down and then put my fingers in the little loops and make them nice and puffy. Pull here and here, and then put your finger in here and kind of pull and see, it makes it really nice and puffy. So cute. All right, and there you have it. So I hope you had fun today with this little tutorial. So now you can go off and make really cute little presents for people and put it on the front of cards, or you can make this little drop-in by itself, or you can make the drop-in and put it in an album. You can put it on the inside covers, would be really, really sweet, but it's a really fun little concept. It's a fun way to add interactive elements to, and you saw it takes no time at all to put these together. So, and then it's really fun to decorate them and add all kinds of cute little stickers and stuff. Oh, and did I show you, wait a minute. You have to see the one thing. This is the thing that slayed me. All right, so cute little card, and look, Graphic 45 even gave me a little teeny sticker. To put in a little teeny booklet. Like, you give me a little teeny sticker, I'm going to use it. So, in a little teeny booklet, I mean, come on. So the decorating is as much fun. The making it takes about, you know, 10 minutes, and then you can spend all day decorating it and having a really great time. So thanks for joining me today. I will put the links down below to the tutorials for the other for these other drop-ins if you want to get into the whole drop-in frenzy. It's a really fun thing to do. So look at all this beautiful Graphic 45 paper in one place. Can you even stand it? I can't stand it. Look at that. That is beauty right there. And guess what? The one that the drop-ins four, so this is drop-ins one, drop-ins two, drop-ins three, drop-ins four is coming with the Wizard Magic of Oz. Oh my God, I can't even wait. So check to look back later in July for that. But in the meantime, go make some of these and I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye.